Are you waiting for housing prices to come down before you buy?
And if you are, what if rates go up?
Hi, I'm Russell with the Stern team at Keller Williams. We're one of the top teams in the state of Utah. I'm here today with Mandy, who's closed hundreds of our deals.
I've been in the business for 27 years, and I can't wait to talk with Russ about the impact of interest rates and what that means for people waiting for home prices to fall.
As we've seen, the markets are crazy right now, right? I mean, prices have been going up, multiple offers on all the different situations. We have a lot of buyers that are starting to pull out of the market and say, you know, they're throwing their hands up and they're tired. They're waiting for those prices to come down.
The interesting thing that everybody needs to pay attention to is what's the impact of rising interest rates if you're waiting for that price to fall? How far does that price have to fall to make that work?
Okay, right. So what does that look like? If I'm buying a home today, looking 400,000, you know, low 400,000, what happens if the interest rate goes up?
Yeah, if interest rate goes up 1%, you're now looking at 357,000 to keep the same payment. I think, you know, we always say as a general rule, every 1% is 10% buying power. It's not to the penny, obviously. That's it, roughly 11%.
What would cause that interest rate to go up?
So there's several factors that could impact that. One of the big hot topics right now, obviously, is inflation. We're all hearing about in the news. But the other things that could happen is demand. We've got a lot of demand here in the Salt Lake Valley. There's a limitation as to how much money a lender has to give. So if there's too much demand, they have to start scaling that back to create more income to have more money. The other thing that we're seeing a lot of is strength of economy. In spite of the pandemic, the economy is pretty strong. And as the economy improves, there's more money in the market, people have more money to spend, and they have more buying power. And then it just goes back to that demand issue.
So today we're what?
High twos, low threes, depending on your circumstances.
As we look at that, you know, we said 1% increase. So if we went up to a 4%, which historically would still be low,
great,
right?
Yeah.
I mean, that's still a great rate if you're in the low fours. So if we look historically on the market, over the last 20 years, we've actually only had 4 years where we had a declining market in Salt Lake.
Out of 20.
Out of 20.
Right? Yeah.
And so in that, in the worst year, 2011, we saw, you know, around a 9% decline in prices. So even in our worst year in the last 20 years, yeah, it's still less than that 1% if it changed. But we've seen, I mean, how many times have we seen 4% over the last 20 years? Probably more often
than that. More common, yeah. More common than that.
Right? And so as we look at what the market's doing and the likelihood of those prices coming down, now we look at the factors. Utah's been one of the top places for businesses year after year. And so prices are starting to come up. We're starting to see our prices look like those other markets.
Yeah.
And then the in-migration, right? So we have people coming here. We're seeing it from Texas, from California, from New York. You know, they love our mountains. They love everything about the state. We're a strong economy, so we continue to push those prices up. Our inventory is still historically low. And so the likelihood of prices actually dropping, especially dropping substantially.
Enough, right, enough to make that impact.
It just, right now we don't see that. We can't predict the future.
At some point, decisions will be made to combat inflation, and interest rates are a big player in that.
Yeah, and inflation is real, right? I mean, it's going
right
on. It's just like, if we think back, you're never going to see gas.
Yeah.
You're never going to see gas underneath a dollar again.
Right.
Right. Right. So it's the same thing with home prices. Like, the reality is, yes, we're, you know, there's demand, the value is going up, prices are going up.
Yeah.
But inflation is happening across the country. So those
right
prices are going to, at some point, I mean, they're sticking.
Right.
What would be those leading indicators for interest rates to go up?
Boy, it is hard to say because it depends on who speaks on which day and who says what, right? Media is a strong push in the market, but by all means, watch for the feds to make announcements that they are going to stop holding those rates in place and they're going to start rising. And if they stop buying mortgage bonds, that'll be a big player.
And when the Fed announces, say they say, okay, we're gonna raise interest rates mm-hmm first quarter of next year.
Right.
When does that take place though? When would you see it actually in your mortgage?
Right, it's gonna be faster than that actual date. One of the things that people don't realize is when these conversations are having, when you see on the news that somebody's meeting and somebody's stating something, a lot of times the market, because of media, the market has already made protections against that, right? So we actually have already seen some upward movement in expectation of overall movement, which is what keeps things from rising drastically. It's what makes it a slow and steady climb. They would have to make some pretty extreme announcements for there to be a fast movement.
If you wait, you know, not only could you have, let's say it even just balanced out, but again, that 1% raise in the interest rate is gonna decrease your buying power.
Correct.
And now it's gonna feel like even more of a pinch. And the other thing that you shared with me that I thought was crazy is I looked at the life of the loan,
yeah.
right? So you can go buy a home at $400,000, you know, $380,000 mortgage.
Yeah.
Not only, you know, do you have the change in buying power, but the reality is the interest that you pay. So I look at this over 10 years, just from a 3-4% on that loan, we're at $50,000 more that you've paid in interest.
Even though you bought at a lower mark. That's the crazy thing. You would think that would balance out.
So one last time in your crystal ball, interest rates going up or prices coming down?
You can wait it out and see if the prices fall, but based on these numbers and based on that impact of interest rate, most likely you're gonna look in your rearview mirror and be disappointed that you held off. You probably won't gain what you think you're gaining in that wait. So if you're still sitting on the fence, worried about whether or not you should be waiting, please reach out to the Stern team, have a conversation, let them walk you through the numbers. I've closed hundreds of transactions over the years with these guys. They're amazing. They take great care of their clients and they will give you the best information you can get out there.
Love to sit down with you and explore numbers, see if we can get you into that next home.